A terrible Jamaican hi to everybody on this earth. I always wanted to keep really nice videos about Jamaica and how good Jamaica is. And well, I woke up this morning just fucking, or yesterday should I say, just a fucking black cloud hit me so hard these last 2 days. I guess when there's no sunshine, buddy, you're talking about black cloud over your head. I shouldn't be making this video. Fucking make this video probably feel better and go on with my life. Where to start at? Well, I guess that's the sun. So let's just start there. I guess it's the sun. Hell, I don't know where in the hell the sun. It looks like the sun, though. So we'll start there. Rained all day long yesterday, and I had to stay most of the day in the tent. And but I woke up yesterday morning and broke as hell because this is what's going on. I've been probably about 5-6 times I've fed families. Maybe 6-7 times. I don't know how many. But I pay for all their food, buy all the beers, buy everything. And when it's done, the last few parties, they want more. They just want to take everything you have. Just drink, drink, drink. And so I just give it to them. And I got $4 to my name, and I don't get paid until 3 days from now. And I ate potatoes and cornmeal and flour and one egg, and that's what I ate yesterday. You know, that little cooking stove that I bought, that's a lifesaver. But to top it off, somebody grabs my stove, tightens the fuck out of the bottle. I couldn't even open it up, man. It took me about 5 minutes to get the bottle opened up. So I pour gasoline in it, and I go fire up my stove, and somebody, literally, I visually seen them with my own eyes tighten this valve up so fucking tight, I couldn't open it up. I almost thought I had to go get a pair of pliers to open it up. And it took me a long, long time to finally open up that valve, thinking that guy, whoever did it, destroyed my stove, fucked it up for good. They wanted to. They wanted to strip the threads. They wanted to do anything they could do to fuck that stove up. Right? So, that's nothing, man. I go buy me a $4,000 Jamaican marijuana plant from a garden. You guys seen it in my videos. Well, I should have took a video of it. They just stripped it dry. Left me probably not even less than a half ounce of marijuana for $40. So everybody came in my house, or my friend's house, should I say. I chewed their asses out. I just called them all a thief. I said, it just takes one of you to make you all become a thief. I'm sorry, man. If find out who did it, and I'll respect you. If you guys don't tell me who stole my fucking marijuana, trust me, man. You're worse disgusting than your fucking friend is. You know that? You're trying to cover up thieves? What's going on with you guys? And everybody I seen, I said, I'm going to see your asses in hell, man, whoever fucking touched my marijuana. I'm going to fuck you up for eternity. I don't like your kind. I don't like you people, all right? You fucking steal from me? You're disrespectful to your brothers and your sisters and to your family, to your mother and dad. You're disrespectful to the whole fucking world. You're a piece of shit. And you know what? They all looked at me, and none of them said, hey, I didn't touch your marijuana. I think they all did it. They came into the house. All my friends took it, except one. Yeah. Yeah, they were all there. They come here every night and they eat. They've eaten my food. They've taken everything that I've bought. And I have to hide everything now. The gasoline that I had for my stove, they used it to light their firewood with. Anything is yours is theirs. They take your ruling papers if it's sitting out there. You'll come back. You won't have no more ruling papers. They'll be all gone. They use your lighter up because they don't want to use their lighter. They just ask for somebody else's lighter. $4 to feed me for 4 days. I don't know how I'm going to do it. And everybody acts like your friend, man. That's what just blows you away, man. They steal from you and they just act like you're just your best friend on earth. Asking for more. So beware when you come to Jamaica, okay? Don't go flash your money around. Set up a special amount every week. So I'm going to spend this much. Don't matter what happens. Spend the first night, then you're just going to live without nothing. I'm going to have to do that. See, in Mexico, this is what I did. I bought all my food for the whole month, which I did here. Right, in Jamaica. And, well, within 2 days, all my food disappeared in Jamaica. Well, in Mexico, I buy a month's worth of food. And I just go party the rest of the month. Have a good time. I'm fed the whole month. I'm taken care of the whole month. And here I did it in Jamaica. Not once. Twice. And seen all my food disappear. Before I realized what was going on. Got a bunch of sticky fingers here. Really a bunch of sticky fingers. I don't have nowhere to go either. So I'm stuck with these thieves, should I say. I call them thieves. I don't know what you would call them. Well, sorry about making this video and disrespecting the Jamaicans. Some are good here. Really, some are good. Very few, though. They give, but they take. more than what they give. Of course, some haven't given nothing to me and I've given a lot to them. A lot of Jamaicans, not just one or two. Almost everyone I've seen so far is talking to me. I've given them a beer or a joint. Yeah, time to stop being friendly and start being friendly to yourself instead. Good philosophy in Jamaica for me. That's too hard for me to do though, because trust me, I've seen a lot of poor people in Jamaica that doesn't have nothing. There's no work in Jamaica. No employment. And the only ones who are working on their land and doing things with their land. Growing a lot. Anything that makes money for them. But then you have the fucking lazy motherfuckers who are not willing to work, and they go up there and they steal everything that farmers have worked for. It's going on. I'm hearing a lot of this going on, guys and gals. This one guy the other day came down, he goes, I want to chop up some fucking body parts. Because I went up to my farm and all my, I think it's called star fruit. Something like that. It looks like a star. Shape of diamonds. Not diamonds, but like a star if you would cut it in half. Star fruit. He said, it's all gone. All of it's been picked. I went up there to harvest it today and it's all gone. He goes, all my mangoes are gone. He goes, all my bananas are gone. And he walks off the hill with his son, man. I felt his pain. You know what? And I told everybody too. You know what? I'm growing this fucking marijuana right in front of you fucking thieves and you're gonna steal this shit from me. I said, you fuckers are worthless fucks. You guys are worthless fucking piece of shit fucking human beings who steal from other people. You shouldn't be alive. You should all be chopped up and buried somewhere. Is what I told them. And I looked at that one guy that took my marijuana the first day, but he came to me and told me. He goes, I took a bud from your plant. I chewed his ass out. I said, that shit's not cured yet. What the fuck are you doing taking fucking uncured marijuana from me? So keep your fucking hands off my shit, all right? It's not your shit to fucking be touching, all right? I'll give it to you when it's ready, when it's cured. Matter of fact, I chopped the plant up yesterday, what was left of it. And it's just wet as wet can be. So I'm smoking some bad shit. Uncured smoke. Because I thought I had a marijuana plant to go to smoke. So I gave all my other marijuana away. Like a fool. Well, don't follow my footsteps if you do come to Jamaica. I'll think you'll regret every step you take. I've enjoyed myself, but these last 2 days, and being broke on top of that and having people steal from me, if I was rich, I wouldn't care. I just go buy me another marijuana plant and just figure out where I can dry it at somewhere so some fucking goddamn sticky fingers wants to take it before you find able to smoke it. This one grower told me, he goes, my last harvest got ripped off. So I seen that grower today and I says, you know what? The same motherfucker stole my marijuana, the same motherfucker ripped you off, for sure. You need to go find out who in the fuck stole my marijuana, because it's the same motherfucker stole the marijuana from you. And all his friends were there. There's two of them for sure that took my pot. Three of them, I think, because they all smoke marijuana who come around here. I haven't seen one of them, so I'm not going to accuse him. I haven't seen him in a few days. It wasn't him. I know who did it. I just got going to talk to the person again. Of course, I already decided not talking to the person a long time ago. So that's probably the reason why he went ahead and did all this shit to me. Because I stopped talking to him a long time ago. You know, when you know bad people are around you and you know they're worthless and they're going to harm you, and you just ignore them and or say hello to them and don't say a fucking word to them after that. Yeah. But I'm going to treat them worse. A lot worse than what I did before. I told those two too. I says, I'm going to do anything if I find out you guys were the ones that took my marijuana. I'm going to destroy your fucking names where nobody will like you. They'll all hate you like I will hate you when I find out who stole my marijuana. They were both speechless, silent, both staring at me, and then look away. Oh, one more thing too. If you're a white boy and you stand in line in front of a store and you give 1 inch a little room in between the seller and you, that 1 little inch of room is going to be taken up by some black guy, okay? Or some black woman. They just step in front of you like the Mexicans do to me in Mexico, okay? Same fucking shit, alright? But reality, worse. So beware and stand in line for a little while or decide just to walk away and go find another store to go to, because it's happening to me all over the place in Jamaica. I don't like making bad videos about Jamaica, but I just want you all to know what I go through every day, okay? I show you the things when I'm happy, and I'll show you the things when I'm really sad in life. And regret every minute what you've done in life. Now, this one marijuana grower has been giving me marijuana every day. Just a joint here and a joint there. Let me sample all the weed around Jamaica. I told him I'm going to go to work with him today. And help him plant all those marijuana plants that I filmed earlier. He laughed at me. He goes, okay, I'll see you tomorrow, Gringo. I said, well, you'll see me tomorrow if you stop by. Oh, one more thing that really wrecked my fucking day today. I found this really good store that sells cheap. They treat me like the Jamaicans, okay? same prices and everything. And I go buy some cookies, and I ate some last night and bought another bag for today this morning. Go look at it. The cookies were made in India. I went, fucking what? And the date was best to eat before June 2015. Well, today is July 11th or 12th, I don't know. It's a Tuesday, 2015. I just said, you know what, God? I don't know what the fuck you're doing to me. You keep me poor. You hate making me eat some very bad shit to survive in life. I said, what's going on? What's going on with your fucked up life and this fucked up world you've created for me to try to survive on? Well, y'all let me know what I'm doing wrong in life. I would like to know.